He can't say.
Extend the use of multiplication rule to include the probability that among several trials we get at least one of the specified event. Consider conditional probability the probability of an event occurring when we have additional information that some other event has already occurred. We provide a brief introduction to Bayes' theorem.
The idea of a conditional probability refers to the fact that something has already occurred. And what happens in essence is that the sample space shrinks as a result.
Complements the probability of at least one. When finding the probability of some event occurring at least once, we should understand the following. At least one has the same meaning as one or more. The complement of getting at least one particular event is that you get no occurrences of that event. At least one occurrence of event A equals one minus P, no occurrences of event A.
It's important to know why we go over this in this manner, because if you want to find the probability of at least one, it may be difficult if you get to go with that literally, meaning one, two, and go all the way to n. However, calculating the probability of none may be easy. If this is easy, then we calculate that subtracted from one. So that's the idea of at least one. At least one. That's why we use it in this manner. So probability of at least one is equal to one minus the probability of none. Let's look at this example. If a couple plans to have three children, assume equally likely and independency. So what is the probability that they will have at least one girl? So there are a couple of ways to approach this. And first, we're going to look at what we have seen before. There is nothing brand new. We did this. We had the sample space. So let's look at the sample space that we had. The sample space that we came up with and the tree diagram, I'm referring you to the example that we have seen. We can see that it becomes 7 over 8. Let me just quickly remind you of a couple of things here. First of all, when we say at least one girl, I hope you see that this is good. This is good. As long as you see a G there, it's good. It's good. We want at least one, good. All of them are good. This is no good, okay? Because we want at least one girl. That's the idea how we get to that. There are 7 of them that are good, so 7 out of 8. How did we come up with that? I want to refresh your memory about this tree diagram, GB. You can go back to previous notes. And so this is G as an example, and you get G, G, G. This is B, and you get B, 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 and I let you fill up the rest on your own. So this is something we have seen. We can answer it this way. It works fine. All is okay. Now, from the point of view of at least one that was discussed, and at least one means one minus the probability of none. Okay, we want to discuss it from that point of view. None would be that all of them are boys. All boys. The probability that they're all boys would be 1/2 to the 3rd. 1/2 to the 3rd. If we were to calculate this, it's easier that way. And 1 minus that is the answer. When we have a case with 3 children, it's really not that big of a deal. It's fairly simple. But the more complicated the question, the better this way. If we have 5 or 6 or 7, it may not be easy to use the tree diagram or write out the sample space. For example, if you have 5 and you want at least one girl, then it's 1/2 to the power of 5 and you subtract it from 1. So therefore, there is a probability of 7 out of 8 that if a couple has 3 children, at least one of them is a girl. Now, the next part is asking, what is the probability that they will have at most one girl? In which case, at most means if we have one girl is fine, and if we have no girl is fine. That's why a shorthand notation is P of 0 and P of 1. So in essence, you can go look at your sample space. P of 0, that means no gears, which is 1 out of 8. And then probability of 1, just look for 1G. 1G, this one has 3, 2, 2, so 1G. There's only 1G here. There's only 1G here. And there's only 1G here. So those three give us 3 over 8. And then the last one is the probability of 0, no G's, if you will. That's how we arrive at this answer. So at least one versus at most one. Here's the next one.
Assume that 3% of ties sold in the United States are bow ties B. If four customers who purchased a tie are randomly selected, find a probability that at least one purchased the bow tie.
This is an example where complementary events and using concept of the P of A plus P of A not equals 1, as well as P of at least 1 is 1 minus P of none, is really helpful. First and foremost, it's important for us to understand when we are dealing with statistics, we are really dealing with word problems. So let's write what's given. So probability of B, and B stands for the bow tie, the probability of getting bow ties would be 0.03 or 3%. And therefore, the complementary event for that probability of B not would be 97%. And in this case, N equals 4. There are other approaches on discrete random variable and the next chapter, but just the way it is here. And so in this case, we are saying that if four customers who purchase, so N equals 4, find the probability that at least one purchased a bow tie. So first, let's figure out what is the probability of no bow ties when we have four customers. Remember, no bow tie for one customer, the probability is 97%. But what happens for four, we are assuming in dependency. So probability of no bow ties would be 0.97 to the power of 4, because there are 4 of them. Let's say there are 10 of them, to the power of 10. I wrote out for you that it means probability of B naught times the next one and the next one and the next one. But an easy way would be to write down as 0.97 to the power of 4. And that means the probability of no bow ties. So probability of at least one would be probability that is calculated as 1 minus the probability of none. 1 minus the probability of none. So 1 minus the probability of no bow ties, which means 1 minus that 0.885, or if you didn't write that intermediate step, 1 minus P of no bow ties would be 1 minus 0.97 to the power of 4. We already have calculated that as 0.885, so 1 minus 0.885. And the answer is 0.115. So if four customers who purchased the tie are randomly selected, what is the probability of at least one purchasing a bow tie is 0.115.